So it's the Pels and the Lakers. It's the play-in, a place where none of us wanted to see New Orleans. I was asked earlier today, doing a show with my guys from Lafayette, RP3, D'Lo, and Mesh. They're in town. The guys asked me, hey, what do you want to see happen? Like, the best scenario, right, is for New Orleans to win tonight. And part of me intuitively says, well, of course it is. Like, you want to win, you want to advance, you want to get into the postseason. And realistically, though, if we're looking at what is, they asked me, like, what would constitute a successful season for the Pelicans? And from my vantage point, we came into this year saying, okay, 2 years ago, you were in the play-in, you advanced. Awesome. The expectation last year was playoffs, had some injuries, it didn't work out, and you missed the playoffs altogether. This year, the play-in tournament wasn't the goal. The goal all year long was be in the top six. Be in the top six, punch your ticket to the playoffs. Show that progress. Well, you didn't do it. So at this point, the only way that I can see us looking back at this season as successful is if you win a series. You've got to advance in the playoffs. It's not going to be good enough to win tonight and then lose to Denver and bow out. You got to advance. So for me, I'm thinking, okay, well, the best opportunity for them to advance is lose tonight, beat Sacramento or Golden State on Friday, and then play a best of seven against OKC because you got a better chance of winning that. Quite honestly, you've been a better team on the road than you have at home this year. So you got this game tonight, and yeah, I mean, I'm sitting there thinking, of course, I'm not thinking of it through the lens of the players, who of course are going to try to win this game, do everything they damn well can to win this game. I'm looking at it through the lens of what's it going to take for this team to advance. And the best play is not win tonight, play Denver. The best play is lose tonight, win Friday, and then play OKC. Until I started to think of another reason why it would be absolutely magnificent for the Pelicans to win tonight, which would actually trump winning a round in the playoffs and then bowing out in the Western Conference semis or however it may look. And that reason is to get rid of LeBron James. To get rid of LeBron James. It is almost unfathomable when you think about LeBron. He is undeniably one of the greats on anybody's list. Four-time NBA champ, four-time finals MVP, four times MVP, 20-time All-Star, 13-time NBA first team, All-NBA first team, five-time All-NBA defensive first team, member of the NBA 75th anniversary team. He was the rookie of the year in 05 or 04. He was the AP athlete of the decade in the 2010s. He is the NBA's all-time scoring leader. And he is hated. Why do you think LeBron is hated? Oh, let me count the ways. Could we go back to when LeBron was coming out of high school and he posed for an SI cover where it said, the chosen one, declaring that he was the one to come when he was 18 years old? You could say, that's not his fault. He posed for the cover, didn't he? Well, what 18-year-old wouldn't? I don't know. One that didn't think he warranted that kind of expectation? Oh, there's other trivial things. A lot of us hate the stupid chalk thing, right? He walks the scorer's table. He grabs the chalk and throws it in the air. And some of you look with adulation and adoration. I look at him like, man, just go sit down. What are you throwing chalk in the air? The headband used to be his staple. Then one time in the middle of a finals game, it got knocked off his head, and then he just decided not to wear it anymore. Whatever. But it's so much more than just those things. Now, here's a guy that gets drafted by Cleveland. He gets drafted by Cleveland. Oh, and he had success in Cleveland, but he couldn't get over the hump in Cleveland. So what did he do when he becomes a free agent? He decides that he's going to leave, but he couldn't just leave in a normal way. He has a big old TV show to announce he's leaving.
And this fall, man, this is very tough. And this fall, I'm going to take my talents to South Beach and join the Miami Heat.
Oh, and then they were ready, weren't they? They were ready in South Beach because LeBron couldn't win on his own. He had to go join D-Wade and Bosh. And you would think, boy, they were just going to rack up the championships. But that's not exactly how it happened. He went 2-2 during his time there. I actually don't count either of those for LeBron because, you know what? You needed a super team and you couldn't even win every NBA Finals you were in. And if that wasn't sad enough, like if that wasn't sad enough, all them people in Cleveland hated you. There was a dude who wrote a book called The Whore of Akron when LeBron left for Miami. And what did LeBron do? Because he's so weak-minded and needs to be loved, he went back! He went back to Cleveland! The people that called him a whore, that booed him, that burned his jerseys, he went back! And won the only legitimate title of his career when they came back and beat the 73-win Golden State Warriors hat tip. That was your finest moment as a pro. But then, of course, because he's LeBron, he had to do what we knew he'd do. He leaves Cleveland again, and this time he goes to LA. But it's not just that. Oh, it's not just that. Remember the 2012 NBA All-Star Game? The 2012 NBA All-Star Game, as the game's winding down, we got this amazing moment where Kobe and LeBron, it's a two-point game. They inbound the ball to LeBron. And then what does he do? D'd up by Kobe when all the crowd is getting loud and they're ready. Hey, here we go. LeBron, Kobe, LeBron, take the shot. LeBron, no, he passes the ball. Darren Williams missed. They get the rebound. It gets back to LeBron. And what does LeBron do? Here's your shot. Here it is. Nope, he passes it again. The chosen one, my... Yeah, right. Tell me Jordan would ever... Tell me Allen Iverson would ever pass on that shot. Oh, there's that. There's... By the way, you realize the reason we have new flop rules in the NBA is because of LeBron? Because LeBron just... runs all over the court flopping and has. I mean, we thought it was the Euro influence. No, it's not the Euro influence. It's your king. If LeBron's a king, LeBron's as much a king as, what was the guy's name in Gladiator? Joaquin Phoenix's character, the emperor, whatever his name is, that nobody respected. Maximus, you know what I'm talking about? Maximus is down there and the emperor's like giving him the thumbs down to kill him. And then Maximus is like, nah, I'm not killing him. Bleep you, guy. That's how I feel about LeBron. LeBron's as much a king as the emperor, played by Joaquin Phoenix in Gladiator, is a leader. What was his name?
Richard. No, I'm sorry. That's
great job,
film.
Muse. Thanks. I'm going to keep rolling here. You know what?
I don't know his name.
And then, despite being 4-6 in the NBA Finals in his career, 4-6, he's lost more finals than he's won. LeBron wins an NBA summer camp title down there with Mickey Mouse watching and thinks that's the thing that legitimizes his career because he won a title with the Lakers, his third franchise, and he comes out with all this, the GOAT stuff. Like, play, this is what LeBron said after the summer camp title.
We just want our respect. Rob wants his respect. Coach Vogel wants his respect. Our organization wants their respect. Laker Nation wants their respect. And I want my damn respect,
yeah,
too.
You want your respect. How about you go earn your respect? How annoying is it as well that LeBron's trying to pretend he's not bald? Dude, we know you had hair transplant surgery. I'm a bald guy, too. I get it. Being bald ain't fun. You want to go not be bald? Okay, go not be bald. But, like, I don't know, I sit out here and pretend like you ain't bald. We all know you bald, bro. Just own it. Bald is beautiful. Not really. If I had the money, I'd probably do the surgery, too. But I ain't you, LeBron. But we can all tell you went and had surgery. And then if that ain't bad enough, this dude is trying to influence future generations of the NBA. LeBron's out there talking about his son, Bronny, and I ain't trying to bring the kids into it. But Bronny just finished up his freshman year at USC where he averaged 4.8 points per game on a crappy team, and LeBron has the audacity to say on the record, if he's not drafted where we want him to go, I'm gonna make a few phone calls. Like, you think you're that golden that you're gonna dictate where a team uses a draft pick to take your son who can't play a lick? Kick rocks, bro. That's why nobody likes LeBron. That's why LeBron's hated. It's the never-ending personality crap you got to deal with this fool. And now LeBron's dragging his good buddy there, Anthony Davis, back to New Orleans. Yeah, Anthony Davis of That's All Folks infamy down here in the Crescent City. Oh, yeah, I'm sorry. What would not Anthony Davis? What's his name again?
I call him Anthony Street Clothes Davis because he's always in street clothes.
That's right. Street clothes. Street clothes is coming back down here for another game. So, look, yeah, I'm looking at your New Orleans Pelicans, and I would love to see the best scenario possible for advancement as deep into the playoffs as possible. But more than anything, I would revel in the opportunity to send LeBron and street clothes back to L.A. without a playoff appearance. So I hope the Pels woke up this morning and ate their damn Wheaties and they're ready to roll, because I want them to kick the ever-living crap out of the Los Angeles Lakers tonight and send those losers and their stupid fake fans who live in Louisiana but wear Lakers jerseys because they don't support the home team. You losers need to kick rocks too, and I'm here for all of that smoke right now. So let's go, Pels. Send street clothes and the chosen one back to La La Land. Let's get on and play Denver, see how we do against the real champs.